Anyways, let's get this going. Let's see what's going to happen as we kick this off and go into our best of five grand finals of the Underdogs Intercontinental Clash number 2. Bottom right-hand side, he's yet to drop a map in this tournament. Our Red Protoss player from all of our team, can he go undefeated? Can he defend his Intercontinental Clash title? It's showtime. Bottom left-hand side, our Blue Zerg player from OSC, Rudy, took down Hurricane in the round of 4. He took down Hawsome in the round of 8. How will his ZVP be today? It is Cham. Wardy, do I know how the prize pool will be split? No, I do not, Cynical Death. I have no idea. I have absolutely no clue. What's the best mic for a streamer? It really depends what you want. Blue Snowball is a super kind of affordable, very solid option. I use a Blue Snowball when I travel and I have to cast while traveling. I take my Blue Snowball with me. Super portable, super awesome. Past that, a Blue Yeti is a good way to move on up if you want another studio mic. There's a whole bunch of other studio mics, but those are the ones that I have used. They're very commonly used, very good quality. Other than that, I mean, I'm using a headset mic now, which is maybe worth looking into, but that's because I got a proper mixer and stuff, and I love it. Like, being able to use a headset mic is so much better because it means I can move around a little bit more freely without everyone realizing that I'm moving around and, you know, stuff, moving away from the microphone and stuff, you know, so it's always good. Anyways, we set it up into game numero uno, Cham against showtime. Again, Cham really has been pretty good in this event. I mean, looked great in the NA group, which he finished first in. He looked pretty solid against Hawsome. He looked unstoppable in the ZVP. Hurricane gave him a couple more issues, but I'm intrigued to see how it goes. Obviously, showtime, though, just looked unstoppable throughout. Not dropping a map when he went through Hawsome and Mana in the group stages. He came through a pretty tough section of the bracket himself, of course. Taking down True in the semi-finals, 3-0. PandaMeMe in the round of 8, 3-0 as well. Pretty crazy stuff. What's up, Koi Pyrus? How am I doing today? I'm doing pretty good, having a good stream. How are you doing, mate? I can actually turn them off even if it's a sensor. Just go to the distribution box and turn them off. Yeah, but I don't know where the fuck the distribution box is. You think I know stuff about where I work? No. God, of course I don't. I actually might just not tell them and just leave them off if that's what they've done, like if they've turned them off or whatever. Because it is better with the studio lights. And if I actually need lights in here anyways, I can just use the studio lights because, well, I don't pay any extra if I use extra electricity. So to me, it makes no difference, you know? Anyways, with that said, let's focus up on this game. Because we do have a Stargate coming down here from showtime to get us started, to get us rolling. You're going to see an Oracle starting to come on out. So Oracle coming out right here, and we're going to be seeing it getting ready to move across the map. Roach Warren coming down from Cham as well right now. And that's just going to be a pretty standard time for him to set up. That said, you got to remember here that in these games from earlier today, Cham did play very aggressively. It's actually interesting. Against Hawsome, he played a very aggressive mid-game style, Hydra Ling Bane. Against Hurricane, he played a lot of kind of Roach Ravager Ling lanes. He played a lot of kind of, well, he played that big Ling Bane all in as well. It's pretty neat, actually. It's been pretty interesting, I suppose, to see how aggressive he's been playing. As he comes in with this pneumatized carapace, he does see the Stargate build right away and the Twilight Council coming down. I mean, we saw from showtime earlier multiple times that he was very fond of the Stargate opener into a Resonating Glaives upgrade. So looking as though he's just going to do the same here once again at the start of this best of five. It's kind of crazy. We saw showtime playing about, I guess it was like 2.5-3 hours ago. I mean, I've had some, the series tonight have been pretty long. I guess the Hurricane True one didn't feel quite as long, but still going to all three games. Even the 3-0 between showtime and True was some pretty ridiculous games as well, actually. Don't forget that, like, True, well, showtime won 3-0. If there's ever a scoreline that doesn't represent what happened in the series, well, it definitely was that scoreline right then. Because there was two games in a row where showtime won because he had, like, 3 or 4 Archons left, neither player had any mining, and all the rest of it. You know, it was crazy how close it was. Like, you couldn't have gotten it closer. in favor of one player. It was really, really quite insane. As you just see, the lair is on the way up. Going to finish up in a moment or so from Cham here. And as that lair finishes, we will just be seeing Resonating Glaives coming up from ShoWTimE as well. So, yeah, I mean, overall, looking at the game, there's the Hydra Den coming down. That's what I want to talk about. Because this is what Cham was doing against Horstam in the round of 8. And I was very intrigued to see him not really do it once against Hurricane. But it is something that we saw True doing in the round of 4 against ShoWTimE today. And ShoWTimE showed us a pretty decent response to it. Seemed pretty confident. The kind of problems were he was going behind because he just kept getting caught off guard by engagement. So, feels as though ShoWTimE has a good opportunity against this. However, I mean, maybe he just wins the game with these Adepts. Because look at this. On the map, 20 Zerglings against, well, 12 Adepts. I mean, it says in the top left. I was looking at the bottom right for some reason. He's going to go up against a lot of Adepts here. And, well, I mean, even if he catches Hydras popping now, that's going to be very easy pickoffs. Already a Queen starting to pull away. As you see, the Adepts are going to start chasing down these drones, etc. Hydra's starting to pop, and that is definitely something, again, he wants to maybe stick close to. And it looks as though they might be able to start gathering together, but he's going to intercept these drones around the other side. He's going to start shading on top of them, and again, Cham just didn't have the units up here initially, and now the Zerglings are running in without the Hydralisks. That won't help out. Oracle's here to help as well. As you still see here, oh, ShoWTimE, I think he's just going to jump on top of this. Those Hydras are going to disappear if he jumps on top, and that's exactly what's starting to happen. Oracles will fly on in to help out. They get rid of two Hydras to the south side so quickly, and 12 workers down. ShoWTimE, a crisp timing. And Cham, were you getting excited about maybe seeing his Hydra, Ling Bane, which has looked like that? Anyways, let's jump in game. Game number 2 of this best of 5. Let's go in. Let's introduce some players. Still yet to drop a map this event. Two more maps, and he's gone for a flawless tournament. It's our Blue Protoss player. Give it up for ShoWTimE. Just been so dominant. As we have to the upper right-hand side of the map. It's our Red Zerg player from OSC Root. It's Cham. So, we set up into this. Look to see how it will go. Look to see what's going to be happening. Proxima Station, one of the more macro-focused maps. When we saw this map earlier today in the PvZ, it was between Cham and Hurricane, and it was a pretty fast... Well, it was a pretty long game, but it ended pretty quick, really. It was actually a weird one, right? Because Hurricane went very all-in. He went for that very fast Immortal attack with one single Immortal. He pushed forwards to see what he could do, and, well, he got kind of shut down because Cham scouted it. And then from there, Cham is very far ahead, but actually Hurricane's harassment kept him in the game for a very long time, maybe even pulling him back at points. And there was a while where he killed the lair, and if he'd killed that one Overseer that was up, he maybe could have won the game just through the ability of kind of killing the Overseer and just spamming some DTs. So it was pretty interesting. It was pretty interesting as we set up into this. Look to see how we're going to go. Probe just moving around, trying to block this drone on the third hatchery for as long as possible. Already Champ, 150 minerals over, so again, delaying that a few seconds always will help out. Trying to, you know, slow your opponent down as much as you can. The more you do so, the better. Queen on the way out now of this main base, so setting this up and seeing how we go. And there's going to be seeing the Nexus dropping down. For ShoWTimE back at home as well. Still yet to see his first tech choice of the game, which will sort of begin to dictate sort of what we're going to be seeing here, of course, generally is the Protoss player who sets up the tech to sort of, again, just decipher what will happen in the early stages. Stargate is going to be that choice as well, and we get to see that right now. So probably very similar to before, maybe just straight to the Twilight Council and going from there. And we'll see if he wants to play, I mean, if there is ever a map to play triple Stargate Sky Toss on, then this would be the map. Super easy to take three bases, fourth base in the center as well. It'll be interesting to see how this goes. We do see this Adept going to shade on over towards the upper right-hand side. So it's Adept from ShoWTimE coming over. And again, just looking to pick up early information. And we'll keep an eye on his Stargate to see, first of all, what he's going to build. Probably the Oracle, probably two of them. Though, of course, just keep an eye back at home in general to see what his follow-up is going to be. As Cham is actually playing with a very late Zergling speed right now. No, he's got 100 gas, but he's not spending it just yet. And he's also not spending it on that pneumatized carapace. So maybe because he feels he doesn't need to, he gets the full scout in the main anyways, sees the Stargate, doesn't really feel too worried about anything else. This time extra gates coming down. It's not going to be as fast of a Twilight Council. I'm just going to be seeing the two gates coming into play. So, I mean, that does suggest potentially some Sky Toss sort of stuff. Two Adepts will shade on forwards and try and go up the ramp. But nope, they're going to turn around and... Nope, they're not going to go there either. What's going on? Now, the two Adepts just pulling back in towards the center here. The Oracle from ShoWTimE will go up the right-hand side. And these two gates will be finishing. We'll be just over halfway done. Still just waiting to see the further tech. You know, second Oracle will pop. He'll probably start a Void Ray to help hunt down some Overlords. Give him a good amount of safety against any sort of early attack as well. That or Phoenix can do a similar sort of thing, but it doesn't give you that sort of added safety as well, as first Oracle picks up three workers. So players generally very good at shutting down Oracles now. Very rarely do you see that first Oracle getting more than two or three drones. And that's exactly the situation here. Three workers is a bit of a push, but it did cost him a little bit more health, of course, on the Oracle. Not so bad, because he can regen the shields. And there is that Void Ray we were just discussing. Still waiting to see the tech follow-up here from ShoWTimE. As we actually see an Adept going a little bit huge. And a few more of these drones as well. So seven workers killed, eight in total as the Adept goes down with one final shot. And it looks as though... Looks as though things are just going to still be pretty slow here. Third next coming down and still no sign of further tech. I do feel as though that means you're probably going to see like extra Stargates here. Out of ShoWTimE. We see the Void Ray. We'll push away an Overlord first to make sure he doesn't get scouted. If he does build more, perhaps, maybe. Yes, no. What's it going to be? I want to know. Robot facility goes down. Okay, and a Forge. Okay, it's just focused on getting the third base up then, I guess. Not going to be that super... I mean, Sky Toss kind of has really fallen out of fashion, I suppose, but... I don't know. You've always got to think about it a little bit. Got to think about it as we do see these Oracles again set up to the top side. A single Zerglin at the front, and we're going to see the Void Ray chasing forwards. Picks that Zerglin off nice and quickly. As we see the trifecta of important Protoss buildings coming up now. Twilight, Robo, and the Forge for the upgrades into the later stages of the game. And, of course, the units which will be making use of those upgrades, the Immortals. So, there's going to be some good stuff then. ShoWTimE just playing super standard. There's Cham. Link Speed about to finish. Hydroden now finished, and Muscular Augments on the way. As we saw, and Stasis Trap coming in here, but... very good response by Cham, only getting two of his drones caught in two separate traps. So that actually works out very well for him. Good response. It's something that we were seeing a lot of lately, actually. These stasis wards doing a lot of damage by trapping a whole bunch of drones at once. But very quickly, Zergs are becoming quite good at adapting to it, realizing it's going on. You know, paying a bit more attention when the oracles are around the base and stopping them from getting those stasis wards up. Or just putting your drones into a good position to make sure it doesn't happen. ShoWTimE not quite able to pick off another drone there. A little bit of miss micro as the Void Ray looking around, still trying to find more overlords. Three kills on it so far this game. Obviously, the more he gets, the better. His extra gate's still on the way up. Temple Archives coming in as well. I mean, one of the things you got to look towards is the potential of an aggressive push in the near future. And ShoWTimE actually never built any immortals. He's going straight into a prism now as well. And he's actually just going to drop Storm down straight away on the Temple Archive. So going for Storm right away. I mean, you got to consider what he's scouted here, which is, well, Hydra's Den. And after scouting the Hydra's Den, Storm is generally going to be your go-to option. Those Hydras have a lot of DPS output, and you do generally need some splash to be able to play against them. So that's what we're seeing ShoWTimE respond with. The Storm coming up, and I have to say, for me, it's 100% the correct decision. Exactly what he wants to go in towards. To go towards all of that. As we see, Lings and Hydras are going to pull through the center of the map here. You're going to see a cannon coming in just behind this wall, a couple of gates as well from ShoWTimE. Going to just be setting up and there to kind of help him block. But this is the exact sort of aggressive opportunities Cham has been looking for against Harstam in the round of eight. And these were the kind of attacks which Harstam really struggled to deal with. ShoWTimE feels as though he might already just be giving up on these first couple of gateways a little bit. I mean, he has to buy some time because he has to wait for Storm to finish. There's no way he can realistically look to kind of sit in this game if he just attacks now before Storm. He needs the Storm. It's essential. As to the left-hand side, these Oracles still around, but obviously they don't want to come towards so many Hydralisks. Opening up the map or the area here a little bit now does definitely help ShoWTimE out because it means he can get forwards and actually attack into this a little bit more easily. As you see, Pro's being ravaged in the mineral line, though. ShoWTimE didn't pull any of those away. And that's immediately got to be a little bit of a mistake, right? As the first Storm comes down, but a good split on the Hydras. Cham pushing forwards again. A couple more High Templar taking a lot of damage. Some more Zealots warping in. It doesn't feel as though ShoWTimE really has that much to shut this down. But it's pretty close overall as well, you know? Like, another Immortal pops out. There's not that many Hydras left over. And a lot of them low health too, and ShoWTimE will push this back. Very, very close. Another immortal on the way up. He could definitely just do with that one extra warp in of seven or so zealots. If he just pulled his probes away from the mineral line over here, how different would this have been? Because if these probes weren't in the mineral line, he keeps so many more workers alive, and now he can afford a few more zealot warp-ins, and that seems to be what he's missing at this point. He's going to warp in an Archon, doesn't have energy to warp in Templar, and wait for energy to be gained to storm. No chance at all. And he's going to see another few probes going down over here. Mortals pushing forwards again. The Void Ray trying to be kept in play also. I mean, four Mortals and an Archon now is actually a pretty scary force to fight against, and the Void Ray will help out too. Any sort of damage will start to go a long way as this Archon is being chasing actually, but wow, ShoWTimE holds on. What a defense in the end. 103 to 80 supply. He's not even that far behind. 20 workers. He's got plus one advantage. I mean, this is the issue for Cham. This attack is very committed. He doesn't have any upgrades behind this. ShoWTimE is about to be a plus two upgrade lead. And of course, he does now have the chance to warp in more High Templar, get the energy to really have the composition he wants against Ling Hydra. So ShoWTimE is just about held on. And from here, it's very difficult for Cham. He's going to have another large bust to try and break through the front, but past that, he's really going to be out of options. If this doesn't win the game for him right now, I don't know if it really will. I mean, storms are about to be available, and in fact, they are available on the High Templar. So he's checking for the fourth base, taking the fourth of his own. But again, where is his upgrades? Where's the follow-up? It doesn't exist, and that's the issue. First storm lands right in the center. Some Hydra's already softening them up. And it just means these Immortals, which there isn't many of, it means they just take less hits to start killing these Hydras, and that's going to be a pretty big deal. Going down in two hits instead of three, for example, would be a pretty big deal for the most part. Is that right? Yeah, 24 damage. So going down two hits instead of three if the storm hits correctly on them. Still needs those storms. Will help against the Lings and Banes as well. In general, it's all just about softening this up and making the immortal shots that much more valuable. And we're going to be seeing another storm here. Cham's army disappearing much faster this time around than previously. And again, those plus two upgrades are still yet to really shine. We're not actually seeing those immortals really come through and chewing their way through the Hydras, but they are starting to make that progress. Again, this time ShoWTimE's economy is pretty stable as well. In fact, across the map, a Warp Prism drops some Zealots into a mineral line, and so the economy becomes dead even, 55 workers apiece. But that's great because it means ShoWTimE has the opportunity to warp in just more units, you know, more Zealots at a time. And that's really sort of the clutch little kind of extra things, which he needs to get in front of those Immortals to make these holds that much easier. As he's actually pushing out onto the map a little bit, thinking about his fourth Nexus, apparently. A few Lings run right on into that army. They don't do anything there. Hydra 4 is still scary, but with 5 storms on his side and more coming in, Archons 2, plenty of Immortals, it's difficult to realistically imagine that Cham can engage into this army. And again, there's another storm, and it's just softening up those first few units and maybe getting ready to go again. Turning, fighting, Hydra's getting ready to go once more. Oh, nice storm once again in the center of all the Hydralis, and again on the edge. Overseer going down. ShoWTimE now really is in control of this game. Yes, it looks as though Cham's in control because he's on the map and he's pushing here and there, but that's only because ShoWTimE doesn't want to push, because he's happy to sit back and just slowly harass with his Warp Prism while he knows he has more than enough to defend at home, and that realistically these attacks of Cham are not going to get very much done. And in fact, all that Cham is achieving by attacking on the map is allowing ShoWTimE to be very effective with the Warp Prism. Another 8 drones go down. This time, if the rock's down, it'll be an attack from two angles. Splitting up these Hydras to some extent is very important, but still, the High Templar are here and still warning away the top side with the storms. More Immortals as well, and Cham knows it's just too many units to push on through. GG, ShoWTimE. Clutch hold. Game 3, and it's a 2-0 lead for ShoWTimE in this best of 5 grand final. To the bottom right-hand side, our Red Protoss player from Armor Team. Give it up for ShoWTimE. What a clutch hold. A couple of Immortals at the very, very end that Cham just could not kill. Just kept ShoWTimE chugging along and kept him alive long enough to push him into that position, which he could then secure the game from. As to the top left-hand side of the map, the blue Zerg player from OSC Root. Give it up if you're going to be cheering on Cham. Game 3, the best of 5, and this is where everything is on the line now from Cham then. Does not want to have come all this way to finish in second place, but so far, ShoWTimE has just been too good. Yet to drop a map in the tournament, we can't say that enough, because that's always going to be an impressive feat. Let's see if you can close it out here. As early game PvZ, we wait to see what tech's going to come on down and look to see how the game will develop over the next few minutes. Overlord scouting early, and we obviously just see it just turning away just in case that's a stalker on the way out, which it isn't. It's an adept, so he can get into a bit more of a position on the main. Pulling away towards this high ground, because if that's a Stalker, it's a dead Overlord if he keeps kind of moving in this direction, right? So, it's a little bit of a safety feature there. As we do have the Adept just continuing to shade up towards the top side and getting ready to go. Shades up here, going to see the third hatchery is about to finish on up. Queen will start a fight against this Adept. Adept pulls away for a couple of moments and has to keep on backing away. Stargate will be finishing very soon from Showtime as well, and there's once again that Stargate build. He likes this, and I wonder what the follow-up will be this time, because we've seen two very different ways for him to follow it up in this series already. We've seen a very fast Twilight Council added on, and we've seen a slower Twilight Council and actually just slower tech in general as a follow-up coming in after the three bases were set up, so it's interesting. As you're going to be seeing the Spellcrawler on the way down from Cham as well. So again, just setting up defensively. I mean, he's already been into the main base then, I guess, right? Or the natural too. Where even is that Stargate? Oh, there it is. So he has seen this. So he sets up his spores, getting ready to defend the first Oracle, which will pop out momentarily. We'll begin to follow across to the top left-hand side of the map. Showtime here, obviously looking to apply some pressure. Let's see if he gets more than those two or three workers, which he's been achieving so far today with those Oracles, or with the first Oracle at least. Alright, so coming up towards the top side, looking to see what happens. We see the two queens coming through, and now we're going to see that Oracle losing its shield, free health as well, so no drones or kills at all. I mean, at the same time, now you can just keep it to the top side and just use it when the second Oracle comes across the map as well. Fast Baneling Nest actually coming in from Cham here. Looking as though he wants to kind of defend against the wave of Adepts, which is coming across the map, but they aren't with Glaive, so I'm not sure how necessary the Baneling Nest really is in this scenario. Is going in towards the upper left-hand side. Let's see what Showtime can get up to. Couple of queens still working their way through an Oracle or so here and there as well, and again, there you go. Adepts will keep on shading forwards. Lings don't actually have speed yet, so slow Lings. I mean, the Banes aren't going to be ready right away either, and this is going to be a little bit interesting as we see he's actually going to start targeting down the Bane Nest with the Oracle. I don't think that's the best use of Oracle energy just yet. He's going to shade the main again. Those Lings without speed, man, they just cannot keep up with these Adepts, and so no real kills going down just yet, but I mean, it's still just continued pressure, and he's continued to be forced into more and more units rather than just droning up at this stage, and even just losing so many of these Zerglings is painful. He jades back down to the low ground. No! Banelings are here. Good decision by Showtime. Sticking around in the main base instead. Can maybe jump in towards the natural with the Oracles and pick off a few drones. Two of them together will sort of work their way through those pretty swiftly. And Showtime already taking an 8-worker lead, and now it's going to increase as he jumps on in, and that's those Oracles doing mega damage. Has to pull one of them back. Actually stuck around a bit too long there. Thought he would have pulled that first one back and then let the second one tank a little bit, but that's not going to be the case. Anyways, behind all of this, third Nexus halfway done, Twilight Forge and Robo Facility coming on up, and Cham is once again going for that super fast third, super fast Hydralis Den, which, again, I mean, is it going to just go for that kind of aggressive Lingbane Hydra attack where he really is on the verge of being all in with no upgrades or anything, just the Hydras and so on, really? You see the Zergling speed is starting up as well here from Cham now. A couple of Robos building. Actually building two Robos. Is that a mistake or is that very intentional? Maybe he just wants to up the Immortal production. Get that going a little bit faster here this time around. Maybe it is a mistake. He's actually got a lot of gas, so I guess the double Immortals would make a lot of sense right now. Even if he starts up a Glaives upgrade or Charge. Yeah, I guess Charge is going to be. So I guess just double Immortals will be coming out here pretty quickly. As you see, a couple more gateways coming on down to the upper right side here. Showtime setting up into these, and Temple Archives coming down too. One Immortal building. Second Robo now finished again, I guess. Yeah, it's like double Immortal. It will just give him those few extra kind of powerful units a bit faster to really work his way against that kind of Lingbane Hydra attack. So, I kind of like the idea. Temple Archives coming in too. I guess he'll try and go quickly into Storm. I do wonder when we see kind of Showtime hitting this point, though, where he's just going to be very nice susceptible trap. At least denying some mining time and forcing units to pull away. But nice response from Cham as well. I just wonder when Showtime, if he's building Storm and two Immortals at a time and plus one and charging, does he have the gas for all of that? Well, obviously if he's going to build primarily Zealots out of his gateways, I guess so. But like right now, he's going to struggle to build an Immortal for a few more seconds. But it's still about there, so it is working out for him. Yeah, it's morphing in, and again, now he can warp in a few more Zealots. And well, from Cham is a little bit less all in than last time already. Going into the Evo Chamber, he is going to start the plus one melee upgrade. No missile upgrade. He really does change these up a lot, actually. And I remember back in the first game on New Kick Precinct, obviously Showtime won with a pretty of a fast kind of adept attack, but he, when he kind of came in, he, Cham was already building the plus one missile attack upgrade, so he does change up which upgrade he upgrades kind of quite frequently, and I wonder if it's just based on sort of what he's playing against maybe, or whether it's just based on what he feels he's going to use more in the game. If he's going to go more Ling Bane heavy, he'll get melee. I don't know, it's interesting. It's one of those things that leaves me wondering a little bit, I suppose. You see the Psystorm, that's about to finish up here from ShoWTimE. So Psystorm finishes and plus two now coming out on this Forge. So plus two on the way up on the Forge. You see, again, the Warp Prism is just over halfway done, and the Immortal will be popping out in a moment or two as well. So Hallucinated Phoenix will get shot down by the Queen. And you see the Overseer just morphing in over into the main base as we do see a Zealot. And a few more Zealots as well coming in towards the top side. Look to see where they can go and look to see what they can get up to. Lings and Hydras are going to start working their way through these rocks, actually. And we'll see a Revelation coming down to allow this Oracle just to see a little bit more of this army. As again, just keeps track of where these units are. I love the Zealots getting ready to counterattack. ShoWTimE looks like he's going to wait with these until Cham is really focused on fighting and attacking, just to really make the most out of them. You know, if they attack while Cham is focused elsewhere thoroughly, then he's obviously more likely to get a lot more damage done with them. Ling Bane Hydra splitting up in two different directions. We've seen a few of these Zerglings getting picked away at. Zealots do start moving forward. It's only four Zealots, not that many. You see Lings and Bane's going to start going over towards the third base and the natural. It's actually an interesting split in ShoWTimE so far, looking pretty good. Loses, I think, a gateway here so far, but cleaned up quite nicely. The Zealots doing a little bit of damage. Not too much, though. I mean, picking off a Hydra or so, now getting shut down by reinforcements. ShoWTimE, more High Temple warping in, and well, he's going to be maxed out in a few moments. He's already making his movement in towards the Sky Toss follow-up now. Fleet Beacon and an extra Stargate start moving in towards those later game carriers and really forcing something else out of his opponent. Stasis Ward pops on the first few Zerglings that move up this ramp. It's actually still a bit annoying because they will still act as a bit of a blocker there, stopping other units from moving up. Army to the right-hand side as well, as maybe Cham looks to try and collapse on this from a couple different directions. Plenty of storms available, but yet to see ShoWTimE use a single one of those storms so far. I'm going to use one right there on a couple of Banes, maybe a little bit preemptive, but I mean, he's actually got the numbers of storms to use anyways, and there's a couple more storms. This time connecting quite nicely on a few of those Hydras. Some Banelings also going down. Still Zealots and Immortals focusing at the front and still holding this high ground. ShoWTimE really doing a very good job of defending on multiple fronts up until now. Maybe now's a little bit more tough for him, but the nice storm again and the double overcharge again, cleaning out Banes. And once more, we see ShoWTimE pushing Cham away. Really good splits, really good multitasking. What do you do against this guy who just loves to defend, who loves to play these sort of games where you're trying to kill him and he's just staying alive and starting up carrier production and getting further and further ahead? And then we've seen again here just units still on this high ground, still pushing this away. And again, Cham, I think, will start to push in towards from the top side. It's pretty much everything. We are again some pretty horrendous lag spikes, which I would say is pretty unplayable for ShoWTimE, especially who's going to have to try and drop some good force field storms as well in the next few moments. So I think everyone was getting the lag there, so no one really knows what was going on. As Cham still very committed to this, he does have plus two melee, remember, this time around, and so I guess the problem still is that as the Protoss army gets stronger, it's still just going to be Ling Bane Hydra, and a couple of upgrades aren't going to make a difference when all of a sudden there's carriers and 10 immortals and High Templar 2 and all the rest of it. So hope to see how this is going to go. Just obviously waiting for maybe Cham to come back or something. We can try and get going again. See what happens. And Cham is back. As we play the same go-go. And we resume. Alright, well, ShoWTimE is right into this engagement. There's Cham pushing towards good storms. Just keeping this unit, these units at bay. This time, ShoWTimE does rotate all the way around with the rest of his units from the natural towards the front, and actually he's starting to push forwards quite aggressively. He's still got storms to use, and oh my god, the storms on the low ground are killing so much. Lings are going to try and make a bit of a move forwards now. He needs another wave of Zealots, maybe. I think the High Templar right now out of energy, and so he does have to start morphing Archons. But they're not ready for a few seconds here. There's the Zealots that are going to help out massively in this. ShoWTimE does push it away. You got to really kind of give credit to just how difficult it is to make that hold, though. Defend on two fronts for so, so long continuously in that situation. Pretty crazy stuff. As I see some more Banelings on the way up, more Hydras as well being built. Zerglings are on the way out also. Plus one ground carapace coming up here from Cham. As these units from ShoWTimE just gathering up out the front. So these units just gathering up out the front, receiving Bane Hydra. Thinking about where he wants to go in from, and thinking about maybe going up this ramp as we're going to be seeing High Templar as well. Maybe ready to drop a few of these storms onto the Ling Bane Hydra. Let's see what he can maybe get done. There's a few Zealots leading the charge, Archons. They'll be obviously wanting to try and tank against a few of these Banes. Finally, carriers have come onto the map. I mean, I'm not sure how much they're really going to start adding to this, but I guess we're about to find out as Cham is being pushed back. Void Ray trying to pick up a couple extra kills. Two more Hydras dropping towards the end here. 13 probes going down. ShoWTimE still holding a pretty substantial kind of army supply. Well, pretty substantial army supply. Not a lead or anything, but still looking okay. I mean, even 61 workers is all right for him here. Just the two carriers. That's all he's going to sit on now as we see Cham once again splitting up into two different directions. I mean, there's still a couple of High Templar Mortal Mothership Core over towards this position. A Stasis Ward 2 to buy time. Cham continuing to expand. This attack looks though it will continue here in a few moments' time. ShoWTimE, what's he got to fight against this? Well, immediately we see the Interceptors flying forwards. Nice Stasis Ward on this ramp. Overcharge? Not really reach anything here as we see. Oh, carriers coming down here. And they're going to start fighting these Hydras. The Immortals moving forwards as well. Suddenly, ShoWTimE's very out of position with a lot of his units. Immortals going in between the army. Archons to the top side don't really know where they're going either. And ShoWTimE loses a lot right there. His Immortals just taking a bit of a wonder as they came down this ramp, allowing the units from the north to come on in and really do some damage. Still storms available though, and ShoWTimE keeps dropping those. Still has carriers alive as well. I think he wanted to send the carriers there, but also sent the Immortals, and that's where it went wrong for him. I can't imagine he thought it would have been a good idea to send the Immortals, unless he thought that was the entire army of Cham. In which case, maybe. Plus three attack upgrades now in game for the Protoss player. Losing those Immortals, though, they're expensive to replace, and they are a big kind of chunk of what he uses to defend. And he might even lose a Roman facility over to this side now. ShoWTimE makes a pretty big commitment. I mean, at the same time, it's a big commitment. These Hydras are all going to go down. So, he is going to be able to chase them down. He is going to be able to get rid of these here. Across the map, finally, ShoWTimE finds a chance to get some Zealots in towards the mineral lines of his opponent, giving some damage of his own. I mean, ShoWTimE's been very much so pinned back to his own four bases for a long time here. So actually being able to kind of work his way through some mineral lines of his opponent just keeps Cham pulled back as well. Losing a carrier not going to help him out though in this situation. I mean, that carrier, I mean, the carriers haven't been doing too much, but they still do add in to the play as we see ShoWTimE ready to counterattack once again with the Prism as soon as Cham moves through the center of the map with what is a hell of a lot of Hydras. And I mean a hell of a lot of Hydras. You know, probably be, I mean, he doesn't even have that much money to warp in that many units over here, though. I mean, Cham realizes that and he's not going to push forwards. ShoWTimE putting himself in a position where he can be surrounded again on this ramp. It's an interesting one to sit in. We're going to see storms to the top side already. Archon's doing a good job over there. Storms now to the south also. ShoWTimE maybe needs just a few more to get rid of the last little bit of Ling Bane that's pushing forwards. That's probably the best fight from ShoWTimE we've seen in a long time. Good storms. Archon's getting good connections as well. Once more though, he's going to have to respond to the attack over towards his natural expansion. Storm still chasing Hydras away. Looks like ShoWTimE will rotate his Immortals around. Now the Archon's getting found though in between these bases and they're sort of getting picked off one at a time as well. Although on the top side, they will sort of win out the fight. It was the ones in the center that really run into trouble. And now Immortals moving down the ramp. Goodbye Zerglings, goodbye a couple of Hydras. ShoWTimE still just about hanging on, but actually overall, this does look better for him than it has in recent times. Prism could come back into play in the main base now, but it looks as though Cham is on top of it, realizing it's there. And Cham says, you just don't die. I mean, I think that's sort of what we're thinking as well. ShoWTimE just keeps on, just keeps on surviving. And I don't think he'll respond, because I feel as though he probably, to some extent, might feel as though he's in a bit of a tough spot now. But actually, his position in the game is pretty okay, as you're going to be seeing. And he's still just gathering together down on this base. Again, ShoWTimE. If any Protoss player you could name that could defend against this, ShoWTimE has to be one of the first that comes to mind. Because, man, he is just the player who has always, for so long, looked to defend and get into the late game and keep on defending. And you're going to see some Interceptors will start off the fight over here. A couple of Banes don't do too much to the north. Storms deflecting the Hydras for now. Match a very convincing win down to the south side. I think now that ShoWTimE has once again stabilized a bit and again gotten some more of those higher tech units up in higher numbers, it's just becoming so impossible for Cham to really push through. He's going to make a bit more of a committed effort towards the south now. Actually, High Templars are forced away from the majority of the army. Archons will Saw Morph in. I mean, the fight on the high ground is going to be won here by ShoWTimE. It's just messy because he doesn't have those storms to start chewing through the Hydras on the low ground. And now a couple of Immortals will maybe go down because of it. Zealots, so on the lead the charge once again, looking to try and tank some damage. ShoWTimE has established a fifth base, and he still has that prism topside, and it's still very difficult for him, though, to decide when the right time is to use that prism. 55 probes to the 72 drones. Income lead has been there for Cham, but I guess the resources loss has been heavily favoring our Protoss player. 35,500 to the 26.4k loss so far in game number 3. And that favors ShoWTimE, obviously, here. But of course, Cham mining most he can get away with it, and it's a large map, so it's not like he's running out of bases or anything. At least not in the foreseeable future. That's a little bit of Ling Hydra coming around the right-hand side, and we're going to see the plus one missiles from Cham about to finish up as well. A little bit more damage output on the Hydras. I wonder how much scarier that makes those guys. Because without that, it's interesting to see. A bit of a different position here for Cham to try and push on in towards. He's still got an army over here as well, pushing forwards, and, well, here we go again. Good preemptive storms just in the front, just to keep the damage coming out on units that start to run on forwards, on those Lings and Banes especially, making sure that not too many of those Banes are able to connect on the majority of this army. A few Hydras up top, and a little bit of an Immortal gets out on its own, but enough units here to respond fast enough. They just need to kind of actually move into position, and, well, actually, the Hydras go down now. Oh my god, the Stasis Wards over here are pretty insane. That's actually huge, because now ShoWTimE can set up to push on into this as the Stasis fades, and that's going to be very, very powerful for him. And you can see him setting up. I mean, obviously, Cham's going to want to try and back away. So you can see ShoWTimE is full on intention to make sure he's not going to be able to back away. Goodbye, Hydralisks! Because this was a big Stasis catch, and now Cham, I think for the first time in a long time, is truly being pushed away from this position. Big prism play to a fresh base of Cham as well. Drones will begin to drop. The hatchery will begin to fall as well, and Hydras will fall back. And now ShoWTimE really is buying himself the time he needs to just set on up into this. You see a few drones pulling through those Zealots. Carrier with some interceptors building right now. We actually see a lot of Zealots down to the bottom left-hand side. And continue pushing up here, and they're going to run on in towards this left-hand side base in the next couple of moments as well. As Zealots going to charge on forwards, and you're going to see this queen going down, and these drones probably going to be in a little bit of trouble as well. So some drones starting to drop, and, well, again, just ShoWTimE now has momentum on his side. He's the guy that's pulling Cham around. He's up in supply. He's only 13 workers down, but up 20 army. I mean, ShoWTimE, I think, realizing it as well, is going to start pushing across the map. Starting to push through the center here as we see still a prism in the main. Just that one Zealot has been consistently coming back in every now and then, just to be a little bit more of a nuisance. And it's ShoWTimE. Still with a lot of units here just moving around, figuring out where to go. Lings and Hydras thinking about coming over to the right a little bit here. More Banelings starting to morph in from Cham as well. Plus two missile attack coming in the main base, and, well, Cham still looking to just defend external bases. ShoWTimE, though, again, with his own kind of position on the map, kind of gathered a little bit more so than previously, is now maybe going to be able to, well, really kind of protect a kind of external base. He's going to start splitting up his units a little bit. He does have to still be aware of potential attacks from the northern side. You're going to see, actually, you can see how eager ShoWTimE is to take fights at points here. So many Archons. That's something that we didn't see earlier that really has been one of the things that's allowed Cham to now start kind of running into bigger issues, allowed ShoWTimE to just start taking better fights because those Archons are super tanky. And when you've got a lot of them, well, they've all gone down now, but now all the Banes are dead. And so ShoWTimE feels very confident continuing to push on in towards those Hydras. And again, it's a fight that comes out 30 army supply in favor of ShoWTimE. 21 minutes in game. It's been a tense game. It's been difficult for ShoWTimE, but man, he's been making it happen. And, well, let's see how it goes. You see the Hydras coming up to the high ground? And it's just going to be seeing Lings and Hydras still looking to see where they want to go. ShoWTimE down to the south, thinking about where he might want to go in the near future as well. A few more Zerglings on the way out, another Hydra or so popping up. The plus two missile attack, not far from finishing. Another huge Stasis Ward coming into these games. As Cham just gets a little bit more impatient in the game, you can see him making mistakes, running into these statuses, just sending large chunks of units forwards without really thinking. He's desperate to try and do something. As well, we see Zealous is going to take down this base quickly, very quickly. He's going to have to ShoWTimE come and respond to this over here. He's actually going to lose a couple of Templar without a Storm being dropped. Maybe focus on the fact that he can catch a bunch of Hydras up top side. His army will still start to rotate down into this position. I mean, these Zergans have been a little bit of a nuisance, and there isn't a wall up into the natural or the main. So that's very abusable right here. As ShoWTimE will lose this base. Some Zerglings on top of High Templar will just about stay alive, the majority of them here. As Probe's pulling away once again, thinking about where they want to go. The Zerglings up to the high ground. Cham, thinking of where to go exactly, pulls on over to the side. As we've seen, a Stasis Ward does pop. Zerglings getting caught. And he needs again, ShoWTimE just continue to defend. Now 50 army supply up. He lost a lot of probes just there, but his army supply is still so dominant in the game. It's absolutely crazy. What a display of skill by ShoWTimE. What a display of skill. I mean, Cham's still trying to expand resources. Lost a dare not look at it. 13,000 difference. Absolutely crazy. Absolutely crazy. A few more Banes morphing in as well to the far right. Lings, Hydras collecting together on the left, also thinking about where they might want to go. Overall, actually pushing forwards here, and we do see those Lings getting caught by the Stasis Ward once again. A couple of Storms coming down right away, and it's going to be seeing those Hydras starting to get worked away. A big army up top, and well, actually, maybe ShoWTimE doesn't have enough to defend all of this down here. It might turn into a bit of a base trade scenario, but well, whoever wins this base trade, I can't believe this carrier is still alive either. That's also kind of insane, as well, Hydra's going to start working their way through this base. It's difficult, man. Like, I don't know who to really call it for. I feel as though ShoWTimE, though, just seems to have so much. And he's picking off a lot of reinforcements. But he has no eco left of his own, so he sort of has to stay on this side of the map and make sure he kills the eco. Because there is more reinforcements coming through. Maybe Cham can do something here still. Lings, Hydra's. A few of them pushing up this ramp. I'm going to start seeing this gateway going down, the cybernetics core as well, probably fall in the next few moments. Some zealots running over to the left-hand side, and we're going to be seeing Spinecrawler poking away at those zealots as well. Hydra's here, able to get rid of an Archon, and again, zealots, immortals, and Archons. Nice storms. He's actually coming in from a couple of angles, cleaning out a lot more of those Hydras. I think ShoWTimE realizes that these units, which are all just split up, are very easy for him to clean out, so that's what he's going to start doing. But he still doesn't have any economy, so actually, 30 army supply down. Cham has 46 drones on the map. ShoWTimE has to start shutting down some of these drones. Oracles are looking for bases to pick off drones from, and well, Cham realizes that this base is very vulnerable to those oracles and does pull away. We'll pop the pulsar beams to get rid of the Hydra and the Spore Crawler. Keeps this base unminable from his really nice storms coming down, cleaning up a lot of Zerglings. ShoWTimE, though, again, he's not got endless amounts of stuff to work with here. As we see drones long distance mining. I mean, what's the income actually looking like at the moment? Cham's not that far ahead. I mean, ShoWTimE's on barely anything. Now you lose some of his last probes coming out of the natural. Still chasing Cham around the map. It's such a large map. If there's ever a map you don't really want to be running around chasing the Zergon, it's probably Abyssal Reef. ShoWTimE's army, though, is still going to be so difficult to deal with. And as Cham stops mining himself, that's when ShoWTimE comes into his element here, because, again, his army's still more efficient as it has been all game long. And it means that Cham really does need mining to be able to keep up and to trade against it. Zealots in the main turn this away. ShoWTimE has a bit of money to warp in or to build some extra units at this point. Coming to the left-hand side, ShoWTimE still just chasing Cham away. Doesn't take down these rocks just yet. Does he have an observer? Yes, he does. So a few of these creep tumors going down. Zealots going to continue making the way up towards the upper right. Looks like he lost one of them to the broodlings. He'll move up here and he'll start work his way through this hatchery as well. ShoWTimE has to be aware that that's one of the bases that Cham will want to try and mine from, and has to kind of try and do something about it, I think. Back at home, he's setting up Zealous to defend his one mining base with his few last probes. And he's completely mined out of the bases that he's had. And I guess that is the one issue ShoWTimE runs into eventually, of course. The fact that if he wasn't able to take external bases, he does run out of locations to take bases in. As we're going to see some queens on their own. I mean, they're going to go down. That's awesome for ShoWTimE because it means that there's not going to be a bunch of transfusers joining the fight. It's a little bit less for Cham to work with once again. Drones are going to be in a little bit of a troubling situation now, because where do they run to? If Storm's able to come down on the ramp, ShoWTimE is really just forcing Cham into an engagement in the near future, which I don't think Cham wants to take at all. Takes down this base, another 7 workers. Now we're going to be seeing ShoWTimE pushing forwards over here, and he's going to run in towards an overcharge, a stasis ward. And that is going to be the opportunity that ShoWTimE needs. And Cham doesn't even try and take the fight. GG. ShoWTimE takes the 3-0. And he is going to win the tournament without dropping.